The Bank of England met today, and for the first time since 2011, three MPC members have voted to raise rates. So, is the bank really close to raising rates, and what does this mean for sterling? Josh Mahony is here with us now to explain what is going on. So, what is sterling doing? It's jumping, right?
Well, it was, yeah, but I see this as a selling opportunity, quite honestly. Now, you can see this in the way that this market has reacted shows how everyone is surprised, because they don't necessarily think, or they didn't think that we were going to be able to see this kind of big split that we're seeing now. Five on one side, of course, to remain, so we did still see rates remain, but three on the other side, and previously it was seven and one. One thing to remember is that one of the members of the MPC is actually, this is the last time that she's going to be voting, so bearing in mind next time round, you're probably, even if the two remaining people did still vote for a rate hike, then you're going to be back to six and two. And also bearing in mind that, you know, look, we've got so much instability coming at us in terms of politics, in terms of Brexit and the like, that quite honestly, it's quite unlikely that you're going to get the numbers to be able to get a rate rise. But if you're looking at expectations in the market, certainly they have adjusted higher because of these votes today, and that's why you've seen a bounce in the pound. But I wanted to show you the sort of longer term picture for the pound and to show you why it certainly doesn't necessarily look bullish for me. So this is the monthly time frame for cable, and we can see here we've got this descending trend line. It could be notable, it could not be notable. Of course, we've just had two touches before and we've come into that area again, and we have been selling off from that area of resistance. If we're looking on the weekly time frame, what we can see is the ascendancy that we've been seeing since the back end of 2016, for the most part, looks like a retracement of that sell-off that we'd seen from September downwards. So this sell-off that we had seen, yes, we had been regaining ground, but for the time being, we still look like we're creating those lower highs, lower lows within a trend, but we're seeing this sort of multi-stage retracement of that sell-off. And if we look at the daily time frame, what we can see, if I then get the Fibonacci onto that level, we go back up here and get the Fib on, you can see all the way onto the right that the 76.4 is pretty much perfectly where it meets this market and where it started to top off. You can see that this market has been selling off quite sharply at the moment, and this daily time frame shows you that we have actually seen a bit of a bounce, but it was selling off very sharply at the beginning of the day. If we look at this wider context, you can see these wide swings coming into here, and considering the fact that these first two moves came into the 76.4, and considering the fact that we have actually only started to see maybe the first half, I think, of the sell-off within this move, I do think we're likely to come back into the bottom end of this triangle that we're trading within. If we look in terms of the 4 hour next, what we can see here is that we saw this sharp sell-off, and despite the fact that we saw this bounce earlier, all of this just looks like consolidation. Look at the sharp move coming into it and then the shallow ascendancy that we're seeing here. This looks like a period of consolidation or retracement before we sell off once more. And look at what happened before, right? You had the sharp move coming into it, the gradual rise, and then the next sharp move. We're now seeing the next gradual rise, and I see it as a selling opportunity as such. And finally, to complete the picture, the hourly time frame shows you we've got these Fibonacci retracements. It's come into the 50 so far. It failed to break through that. You can see so far that the high that we have seen with this spike came back into that 50, failed to take out that previous high. You can see this potential sort of topping pattern that we're looking at here. So it's starting to reverse already. Bear in mind, we have got a speech coming from Mark Carney later today at Mansion House. That's going to be absolutely crucial because Mark Carney still remains relatively dovish. So for the time being, everyone's thinking it's a big shift. But bear in mind that we've got one person out of the three that's going to be leaving for the next time round. Mm-hmm. And we've got Mark Carney that essentially is going to probably come out later today and appease the minds of the people within the markets, because we are seeing the FTSE selling off quite sharply. That's not something he necessarily wants, and therefore he's probably likely to sort of push it the opposite way. So I see this as a selling opportunity.
Okay. For the majority, though, the reasons for policy being kept unchanged include slowing consumer spending and economic growth. Is at the forefront of our minds right now, and presumably Brexit negotiations until we have the next meeting.
Well, yes, and we don't even know whether we're going to see Theresa May out for the next 4 years, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, in a couple of weeks' time, for we know she might actually leave, so we could then be back in another position where we call another election. Now, someone asked me whether it seems likely that we would call another election. It seems quite ridiculous to do so. However, bear this in mind, right? Theresa May called an election on the pretense of saying that she wanted a bigger majority because that would allow her to push through whatever she agrees within these Brexit negotiations. She now doesn't even have a majority. So we could come down the line where they've just spent 2 years negotiating, they come out with a deal, and you've got on one side the Remainers and on the other side the more hardline Brexiteers. And either side's basically not going to be happy depending on what they come out with, and they're going to vote it down. So they're not going to be able to push anything through. Theresa May's probably going to know that anyway, and therefore we've got a good chance of another general election coming up, and against that kind of backdrop and Brexit negotiations, and we don't know what's going to come from that, I wouldn't necessarily rule out another election.
Wow. OK, Josh Mahony, thank you very much indeed for your time today. We appreciate that. We'll talk about the pound in light of the split at the Bank of England.